We all intuitively know that the Earth is complex. We know that it is composed of many components, for example, plants, animals, rocks, water, air, etc., and that there are many processes, for example, plate tectonics, precipitation, volcanism, erosion, decomposition, etc., that connect and change these components. Indeed, that is why we refer to all that makes up of our Earth as the Earth system. By a system, we mean that the Earth is a collection of components and processes that are connected together and work as a whole. Indeed, you are familiar with other systems as well. In human biology, you study the circulatory system or the respiratory system. In automotive technology, you might study a car's exhaust system. To better understand a system, we often take it apart and look at individual components or processes. And we will do that in this class too. However, we must always remember that all the parts are interconnected. Studying the parts individually does not always give us the full picture of how a system works. Looking at the photo shown here, what are some of the important parts of the Earth system? One of the first ways we can break down the Earth system into simpler parts is to break it into the four environmental spheres. Though notably, each of these spheres has many parts too. First, the lithosphere, which is the solid Earth. Next, the hydrosphere, which is all the water in the Earth system, including the ice, which is also called the cryosphere. Next, the atmosphere, which is all the air in the Earth system. And lastly, the biosphere, all life in the Earth system. Life in the air, life on the ground, life in the ground, life in the sea, etc. You should be able to define each sphere and give examples. To review, see your textbook. Also, we must remember that all the spheres are connected and overlapping. Consider soil. Most people would correctly note that soil is part of the lithosphere. However, it also contains components of the three other spheres. For example, consider soil moisture, soil gases, and soil bacteria. Next, let's briefly consider what the energy source is for the Earth system. There are two energy sources that drive all processes here on Earth. First, and most importantly, the sun. And then secondly, the heat within the Earth. This is heat that is still present from the formation of the Earth and also present due to radioactive reactions. Okay, so we understand what a system is, and we've begun to break down the Earth system into its parts. And we also have a basic understanding of the energy sources for the Earth system. Next, let's step back and look at one more general feature of systems. Systems can either be closed or open. Closed systems are self-contained and are not influenced in any way by things and processes outside the system. For example, the Earth system is essentially closed to matter. That's material that has mass and takes up space. No discernible amount of matter enters or leaves the Earth system. As a more specific example, consider water, which is a type of matter. The Earth is a closed system in relation to water. Virtually no water enters or leaves the Earth system. Thus, we have the same amount of water today in the Earth system as we did 100 million years ago, and as we will have 100 million years into the future. In contrast, an open system allows flow in and out of the system. For example, our Earth system is a closed system for matter, but an open system for energy. The sun's energy is continuously entering the Earth system, and heat energy is continuously leaving the Earth system.